meet this man. On a Saturday morning, he is sleeping. No food to eat. Hey! Panda shall never end. Get up.
What's the
point? I need money to cook. Get up!
Woman, what's your problem?
I need money to cook. Get up!
What's your problem, woman? What
do you need, man?
I need money.
Lazy man.
I have seen that.
I need money to cook. I have decided to rest in my house.
On Saturday morning, and you have decided to become eaten in my flesh.
Money to cook.
What is your problem, woman?
Money to cook.
I see. I am not having a problem with money. I need to cook.
The children need to eat. I have to eat.
You can spend money. Must I be the one to spend?
Yes. I need money.
I don't know how.
You remain asleep. Your fellow men are out there puzzling. Give me money to cook.
I find myself with you. I don't know. Even more than the Bible says in the book of Genesis, chapter 2, verse 18, that a man will leave his parents, his mother, and father to cling to his wife. I don't know how I would have found myself with a nonsense in your Christian.
Hey! You call me nonsense. You call me nonsense. Have you not read in the book of Proverbs chapter 18 verse 22 that he that finds a wife finds a good thing and obtains fair? Check me out. Check my skin. I be good thing. Even the Bible recognizes it.
Good thing.
I be good thing.
Bible recognizes you. Good thing. Have you read in the Bible, in the book of Ephesians 5 verse 22? That wives be submissive to your husband. I am here talking. I am here relaxing, sleeping. You leave your to come and defend me. Are you submissive to me?
When you ready, you didn't go down to verse 25, Abby. You didn't go down to verse 25. That says men should love their wives. You love me. Do you love me? Do you love me?
What is your problem, woman?
Bible.
What is your problem? So it has now come up to the point when you are quantifying my love for you because of food.
Yes.
What kind of a woman are you? I don't know. You have plans of destroying this home, but I have something to tell you. It will not work because this home is built on the solid foundation of Jesus Christ. Haven't you read in the Bible, in the book of Proverbs chapter 14 verse 1, that a wise woman uses her hand to build her home, but a foolish one scattering it with her hands? I see you have plans of joining home, but it will not work for you.
You say scatter?
Yes, scatter.
Who said carry strength or scatter? Me now, not even for the past 3 days. You say scatter? me scatter. Haven't you read in the book of 1 Timothy chapter 5 verse 8 that a good man provides for his home?
I'm not a good man.
Any man that does not provide for his home is worse than an infidel.
You are worse than an infidel. Are you indirectly saying I'm a cheat?
It's not in the Bible.
Because of food. What is your problem with food in this house? Must you always snack every day?
I need to eat. I've
not eaten
for 3 days.
In fact, I think I've taken enough from you. I will teach you the lesson. Because if the Bible does not tolerate nonsense. Don't you know that in the Bible, in the book of Psalms 2, chapter 13, the Bible says, withhold not the care of correction from me, from the child. I think it's high time. You are nagging this house so much. Just wait for me here. Wait for me here, woman. You will get. Just wait for me here.
Bring the money. Where you're coming, you bring the money here. You bring the money now. You want to come and beat me? Let me anoint myself. You want to come and beat me? Don't know my anointing. My prophet, you don't have.
I'm beating myself.
Where is she? Come and beat me now.
What are you doing?
Haven't you read in the same Bible? Eh? Some don't know where they sit. Some don't are anointed, though. And do my prophet know her. I'm God's prophet. I'm anointed. I've anointed myself. Come and beat me now.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for watching this interesting comedy episode, The Prophet Comedy, the scriptural quarrel. And we believe you enjoyed this comedy. Here talking to you is your well-known comedian, Mr. Theo the Prophet. And here we have
Joyce Yaffe. Hi, viewers. Hope you enjoyed the comedy. But please don't just focus on the laughing part. We advise that you focus on the message behind the comedy. Because nowadays, most Christian homes, you see, people turn to use the word of God to back up their bad characters. And that is not how it should be. When we read the word of God, we should try to understand it. The word of God is meant for us to build up our character and not to use it the other way around. So please focus. Don't just focus on the laughing part, don't just focus on the comedy, but focus on the message behind the comedy. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time.
Yes, exactly, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for watching the comedy. It has been a wonderful comedy. Just to support what Yaffe just said, we should actually ask for wisdom from God, because you cannot run your marriage. You know, there are young couples out there. You can run your marriage on the basis of using scriptural verses to back up the wrongs you're doing. But in everything, ask for wisdom from God, because only wisdom can provide you with every solution in every marriage. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we know you enjoyed it. It was a real nice time on you, but we can't stay back. But we need to get out of Studio 404 here. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching.
I also the thought of the nagging woman.
She actually the thought of the nagging woman, ladies and gentlemen. But I suspect you're nagging in true life.
Suspect what? I suspect that you're lazy attitude. Provide for your home, demand you to try.
Come on, man, please come.